To start a new rig with Duik Inverse Kinematics, first start a new project in After Effects. Then go to File, Import, File. Select the arm that you want to use for your rig. Make sure you import it as a composition retaining layer sizes. Double-click on the composition. Notice that I have three layers, arm, forearm, and hand. These are all individual labeled layers. This will make sure that you lock the layers so they don't move. Then go to File, Scripts, Run Script File. Select the Duik Bassel script and open it. This allows you to run the script without having administrator privileges on your computer. It's a good idea to click the wrench, make sure you're in standard mode, and apply the changes. Now, click on Rigging, Structures, and create an arm structure. Duik creates this structure that has three pieces. We need to line those pieces up with our artwork. Zoom in, and start with the root of the structure, the arm. Place the rotation point where the arm would rotate. Click the next structure, and place it where the elbow would rotate. Notice that sometimes it's difficult to click this piece, so make sure you click farther down, otherwise you will move the structure. Put this by the wrist, then off-click, click the hand tip. Now the structures are in place, but we still need to parent the artwork layers to the structures. Go ahead and unlock your artwork layers. The hand gets parented to the hand. The forearm gets parented to the forearm. The arm gets parented to the arm. Now we can lock our layers again. Select all of the structures, go to Auto Rig, and click Auto Rig. Duik has now rigged the structures together. We can now hide the visibility of the structures, lock the structures, and then shy the layers that we don't need. Click the Shy button for them to disappear. With the hand controller selected, we know it's a controller because it has C, press P, then hold Shift and press R. Notice that rotation is at 0, but the position keyframes are very hard to remember where they are. We can fix that with Duik. Expand the Duik menu, select the hand controller, then click 0. This creates a null object that the hand controller is now parented to. Now we can have a 0 position. If we click the hand controller, we can now move the arm and it moves with us. Notice that if I pull too far, the hand stretches. We can fix that in the effects controls by unclicking auto stretch. We can easily go back to the beginning by pressing 0 in the position because we zeroed everything out. Now we can set a position keyframe, move forward, move the arm, move forward, and then we can go back to 0, press N to constrain the work area, and then do a RAM preview by pressing the spacebar. Now we have a looping animation with Inverse Kinematics.